Alright, this video is about knowing your personal limitations, acknowledging them, but having the courage to do something about them as well instead of hiding out. So, last November, I had a mouth sore. No particular reason, just your everyday mouth sore. The problem is that we are working remotely at the moment, right? A lot of phone calls, a lot of Zoom meetings. And I discovered while I was talking to my mom on the phone, when you have a mouth sore, you want to say everything as concisely as possible. And my mom misunderstood a number of things. And the problem with my mom has this quirk. As soon as she thinks she knows what I said, her mouth becomes a tsunami. There's no way to correct anything. And I apologized to her. I think she was trying to teach me a lesson that I should think before I speak. I had a mouth sore. Anyways, so I did take that lesson. I had a meeting with my boss later that week. It was supposed to be over Zoom. And I thought I couldn't handle the mouth sore and all the mistakes I made with my mom. So I explained to my boss, can we type it out in email? I feel unwell and I'm not going to present very well. This was in November when we had another spike in cases anyway. So I kind of used that as an opportunity. I probably didn't have COVID-19, but I wanted to avoid having to use my mouth so that I could avoid problems like that. Now, earlier this month, I had to download a 1099 form from my investment account, but I wanted to avoid looking at how my investments are doing. I didn't time the market very well trying to buy silver when we were silver mining stocks when we were short squeezing, but I know I have to hold on to them. All my machine learning indicators, all the information that I have, but I didn't want to look at it. I also didn't want to look at how much I was up with the rare earth mining stocks because I didn't want to have a bad idea of trying to convert that to something else. I'm in it for the long term. But I had to download the 1099, so I quickly went in there, quickly did. I closed everything out before I could think about it. And so today I also have some mouth problems. Not as bad as November, but I acknowledged it, and I had a very low-stakes discussion with my boss today, and I did it. And I think it's important to not hide out from your problems. Right? I see so many people. I used to have a friend who had quit smoking, and one day he and I was making fun of a restaurant that he and I used to love, that they hadn't banned smoking until the whole state had banned smoking. This was in the late 2000s, maybe early 2010s even, and I joked with them how stupid that restaurant was, because toward the end of the time when restaurants still allowed smoking, I became very health conscious and I stopped going there, and he and I were joking about that, and he said that all this discussion about the restaurants allowing smoking was making him crave a cigarette. Could we please change the topic? And then I realized he had quit smoking for 3 years at this point. He can't even talk about a restaurant. He doesn't even live in the city where that restaurant is, right? I had a bad feeling about him. And sure enough, he went back to using nicotine. He vapes now. And so it made me realize that although you have to acknowledge weaknesses like that, you can't hide from them forever. You're going to make yourself think that you can't do something again, right? So my friend, he probably spent a lot of time avoiding that restaurant, avoiding smoking situations, even avoiding talking about smoking, to the point where he can't even, his life is kind of crippled, right? If there's any discussion about which restaurant to go to or his opinion on smoking bans, he's out of it, right?